second one is Russian dolls. In the first one, they were 25 years old, and the second one, 30 years old, and in this one, they're 40 years old. So what's different in this movie, even for me, is that I'm dealing with the same character in the last 15 years. So I really look at them as they get old, as they change. You know, in this movie, they have children. And so it's really about watching people throughout life, in a sense.
Was it always your intention when you made the first films that you would continue with these characters, with this story, as far as you have now taken it?
No, I had no idea when I made L'Auberge Espagnole that I would do a follow-up story, a sequel. Even 2 years after the movie, a lot of people asked me, will there be a following story? And I said, no, I don't want that. So it was strange to see that people, the audience, wanted to have a following story. So it took me like 3 years to accept that it was a good idea. And in fact, I really wanted to work again with the same actors. So I said, okay, let's do that. And I had an idea for the second one, for Russian Dolls. So then I accepted to do it. But then when I did Russian Dolls, I thought it was a good idea to do a third one. So I knew that 10 years later, there would probably be a third one.
Why do you think audiences have responded so well to this particular collection of characters, particularly Xavier, our leading man? Why do you think people have been so determined to see what happens and to see their story continue?
I thought about that the other day, and I think it's because the ending is not an ending in L'Auberge Espagnole, and you feel like you're frustrated at the end of L'Auberge Espagnole, so you need more. So I guess that's the main reason why people thought there would be something planned. What was funny when I did Russian Dolls is I did plan things about when I was working with the actors. I would tell them, okay, you want this to happen, but it's not going to happen in the story. So as we created the characters, we put more things that would happen in the future. So I used that in the second one. And for example, Kelly Riley, the English character, I told her, you're in love with Xavier in the first film. And we never said to Romain Duris that she was in love with him. So in the second movie, it was easier to find a relationship between the two of them because she was already in love, hiding that to Xavier. So it was funny to just follow the line and create destiny or invent the rest of their life with what was planted before.
Of course, audiences all around the world have been falling in love with Romain, but you discovered him. So can you tell us a little bit about that process and working with him when he was so very young?
I met him when he was 19 years old, and probably what was striking when I met him is that he was a character. He was very spontaneous, he was very shy, and it was probably the combination between being shy and being very expressive which was interesting. And now it's probably the opposite, which is interesting, because he became a real actor. He didn't want to be an actor in the first movie. And so it's funny to see that now he's got skills. You know, he's really professional as an actor, where he was really unprofessional, and that's what was interesting at the beginning. And now he's professional, but he kept his spontaneity and probably a very strong relation to the instant. So he's really with the person he's talking to, with the actors he's acting with. And probably that strength is the same as in the beginning.
Talking about the actors he's working with, for fans of the series, how many familiar faces are we going to see back this time? Can you talk us through the rest of the cast?
So Kelly Riley is in the movie, and Audrey Tautou, Cécile de France, and Romain Duris. That's the four left throughout the movies. Yeah.
I guess, what are you hoping the audiences are going to take away from this particular chapter?
It's just that life is unpredictable, very often complicated and hard to deal with, but that's what's great about life. So that's really what I wanted to express in that movie, because very often when you deal with 25, it's easier to give a nice feeling to the audience, because then people are young and they're beautiful and everything's easy, or even if it's complicated, it's funny. When you're 40, you deal with things that are more deep and complex and very often hard to deal with, but it's still interesting. So probably that's what I wanted to say in that movie, is that when you're 40, it's not the end of a life. It can be the end of being young, but it's really a beginning of something else, and that something else is interesting.
And is this the end of the series, or would you like to continue to explore the interesting things that come after 40?
If I do a fourth movie, it would be in 10 years from now, and I don't know what's going to happen in 10 years, so I prefer to say that it's the end of the trilogy, and I think I really worked on the fact that this movie completes the three movies, so for me, it's good if it stays a trilogy.
Is there anything else you're working on at the moment? Do you know which story you'll be telling next?
No, I'm thinking about it, but the movie is going to be released in December in France, and I'm probably waiting for the movie to be released to really decide what direction I'm going to take.
My final question, you're bringing the film here to the BFI London Film Festival. What does it mean to you to be a part of this festival, and what do you think distinguishes it from other film events around the world?
I'm really glad to be here because I love London and I love English people and I love English actors. So it means a lot for me to be here. You know, when I came in England a long time ago, 15 years ago, to meet Kelly Riley and then Kevin Bishop, it's really when I realized that I love the English way of acting, which is really unique in the world. And so for me, it's really important to show the movie in England, because also I know that in England, you don't see many foreign movies, you know, probably a lot less than we see foreign movies in France. And so I know that it's not that common for English audience to see French movies. So I hope they're going to see it, yeah, and enjoy it.